that to dissolve the yeast.
What do I do?
Okay, it's on.
Oh.
Okay. Hi guys, it's your awesome life. Today we are going to be making these at-home baking kit Auntie Anne's pretzels, and they look pretty delicious to me. We were kind of on the fence about if we wanted to make something salty or sweet, because I'm kind of in the mood for both. So we're gonna have salty and sweet, cinnamon sugar. Yeah. So I'm gonna zoom on down Katelynn. Hi Katelynn, say hi to YouTube.
In this box we have
some flour,
some baking soda, and some salt and some cinnamon sugar.
Directions. I wasn't really expecting this. I was just expecting, according to the box, mix, twist, bake, enjoy. That sounds pretty easy, but no, we have this entire, like,
it's a nightmare.
It's like a manual. It's like a manual on how to make these damn pretzels, and I was expecting easy. Oh, and it comes with dry yeast.
Okay, so first, you gotta dissolve the yeast in this here packet. In a bowl.
Plug the TV.
No.
And then you add.
That's water. Actually 1 1/3 cups water, so yes. I'm gonna let you guesstimate.
I couldn't remember. Do I just put all of it in here?
No, just put like, nah, actually that's a little less than one cup anyway. So yeah, 1 1/4 cups water in the bowl with the yeast. I'm sure it won't make that much of a difference if it's not exact, but
to hell with it.
So we're gonna let that lovely yeast mixture sit for like 2 minutes. Hang on. Okay, so Katelynn's putting the dry mix into the yeast water concoction.
Saying that, but yes.
Okay,
go.
It says to mix with your hands, but ew. Okay. So we have a little problem. As we said before, the at-home baking kit is a little complex. We were expecting it to be quick and easy so we could do this video together. So kind of like the onigiri video, this is a little cooking with Katelynn and Emily episode 3 is a little messed up, but we're gonna mix this dough together and we're gonna let it sit for like 30 minutes so the dough can pick up the yeast, and then we're gonna pop them in the oven, and I'm gonna bring one to Katelynn tomorrow because she's gotta go home.
Yay for pretzel.
Yay, dang it.
Darn, poo.
So the next step is to take a bowl and lightly put a little grease on there. And this is olive oil. Put the dough inside and put some plastic wrap over the top so it doesn't get all dry. And you're gonna let it sit for like 20 minutes. Preheat your oven to 425 degrees. Okay, now we are going to roll this out.
Chasing rabbits, and you know you're going to fall.
So the goal of this is that you want it 1/2 inch wide, which is about the width of your finger, and 36 inches long. But I'm not really following that, and I'm just kind of going until it is about the width of my finger. So what I'm doing here is just working with it and making it long and pretzel-y, just like in the mall at one of those pretzel stores. See? It's already... There we go. Easy! And there's our big long breadsticks, essentially. Our pretzel dough ropes. So according to our lovely label right here, it says to mix our packet of baking soda, which I really hope in watching this video you have not added it to the dough. You need to take this baking soda and put it in 4 cups of quote unquote very hot water, which with the magic of television I have right here. And when they say very hot, they only mean 150 degrees Fahrenheit, so that doesn't mean, you know, boil it.
and we're going to use a different tray to roll out the pretzels into their pretzel shape. So we're going to shape this into a U, like this. Then we're going to cross it over, like this. And then we're going to twist. And then we're going to lift and pull down. So just like that. And here are our not entirely perfect, but pretty good pretzels. So we've got kind of a conveyor belt system here. We have our rolled pretzels, and then we have our dissolved baking soda, and we have a almost like a drying sheet, and then next to that is our greased trays where we are going to put the pretzels. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take one of the pretzels. Let's tilt this camera up a little bit here. Okay, you're gonna take one of the pretzels, and then you're gonna very gently, quickly dip into the baking soda water mix, and then you're gonna set it onto your towel to dry. So we're gonna do this again, and be kind of careful that they don't fall apart. So because there's eight of them, we're gonna make half of them salt and the other half are gonna be cinnamon sugar. The cinnamon sugar, once you lay them out on the tray, you're done. But for the salt, you open up the bag and you sprinkle as much salt as you want on the pretzels that you want salty. And then you put them in the oven. Okay, now as for baking, you're gonna do one of these at a time. So we're gonna put in the dessert pretzels first. And we're gonna leave that in there for 5 minutes, and then after 5 minutes, we're gonna take it out and rotate the tray so that they get cooked all the way through. And there we go, Auntie Anne's pretzels. Lots and lots of work went into these.
There's not a standout pretzel that I've ever had.
Mmm. Where is she? Delicious. Bye, guys.